Jackson, who's been a nice addition because of the injuries. Of course, Matt Cook out of the lineup for the Vancouver Canucks, injured in game one of this series. Nordstrom moves it along for Robidoux. Short outlet pass, Erickson, right side. Nagy now for Modano. Goes wide into the zone. Modano gets the shot away. Deflected wide of Luongo. And Daniel Sedin hands it off for Henrik. Far side now. Centering attempt there was blocked by Boucher. And it's cleared all the way out to center ice.
Well, active are the defense right now for the Vancouver Canucks. Mitchell walking up there, trying to join the rush. The defense have been told now, try to activate yourself when you can. And that's what they've been doing.
Gary Lettinen, crowd reacting to a hit by Cowan behind the play. As it is sent in wide of Luongo.
And there's Brendan Morrow back. So Morrow was just an equipment problem. It's good to see him back.
Now moving in is Boucher. Puck knocked away from him, but Modano there to support. Sends it toward the net in wide of Luongo. Now taken by Trevor Daly. Missed by Morrow as he tried to get a glove on it. Now Salo taps it along. Morrison up the left wing side. Cowan, that hit Brendan Morrow, but it's recovered by the Canucks back the other way. Here comes Naslin. Naslin tied up by Trevor Daly. Big hit by Ott. The puck wasn't there yet. The crowd wanted a penalty. I'm surprised we're not going to see one.
Yeah, second time this period. But Ott, who's known as being an agitator and physical player, ran into the Vancouver Canuck player there, and that could have been interference.
Olin sends it behind Turco. He couldn't get the stick on it. Here's Smolinski. Tried to dump it toward the net. Chip back in now, and Clem plays it along for the Dallas Stars. Hagman tries to clear, held in by Vancouver. Up there, Sidor to clear it, and Hagman just plays it safely to center ice. Dallas still without a shot on goal here in the second period, and yet they don't seem to be bothered by that. Here is Bullitt back to the line, a drive here. Save off the stick of Sokol. And it's taken by Stu Barnes. He gets to the red line, drives it behind Luongo.
And one thing that's changed for Vancouver is they're starting to get their point shots through.
Henrik Sedin sets it up, and Hyatt was played well as he was angled to the boards by Stefan Robidoux. Lundqvist, who has the game's only goal, chips it ahead for Halpern. Here's Robidoux joining the rush. Robidoux kicks it in deep behind Luongo. Still control, dumps it toward the net, hit off the side of the goalpost. And now Barnes chips it along for Halpern, but Krejcik able to clear it up the boards. Now Robidoux moves in, kicks it for Barnes. Barnes in deep. Sends it back along the end board. Halpern trying to get in on the forecheck. Henrik Sedin chips it along. Bieksa out to center ice now. Daniel Sedin takes it into the Dallas zone, but immediately checked off the puck. Looking for a penalty is Joel Lundqvist, able to get it into the Vancouver zone. Nagy trying to lift the stick of Mitchell, nearly got in there.
Nagy showing speed there, showing quickness, and how he's a darter. They obtained him from Phoenix for that reason.
Ribeiro tries to put it out in front, but it's picked off by Naslin. Snaps it across looking for Mitchell. Out of his reach, and the Dallas Stars turn it back at center ice. Here's Hagman with it. Into the Vancouver zone, sets it up now. Nagy for Ribeiro, back to Clem. Moves it along, but it's chipped away and recovered by the Canucks as it comes down to Hansen at center ice. Henrik Hansen into the zone. Goes wide on Sidor. Sidor able to pick his pocket. Takes a hit from Naslin. Now Nagy tries to clear, but it was blocked. Here's Naslin with it again in deep. Under 6 minutes to go here in the second period. Centering attempt doesn't get through. Now Clem backhands it along. Salo moves in. Sammy Salo, the defenseman, takes it in deep behind the Dallas net. Hands it off for Hansen. Now for Naslin. Poked away from him. Naslin able to get it back. Now it comes to Morrison. Gets a shot away through traffic. Didn't get all the way through to Turco. Now off between the circle. The chance here. Save rebound opportunity. And Morrison couldn't pull the trigger. And that was held in at the line. We got a penalty coming. And we'll get the call when we come back. And Bob Beers will visit with Rick Bonus, the assistant coach of the Vancouver Canucks.
In the end, all roads lead to Dodge Ram. That's because Dodge Ram is the longest-lasting, most durable line of full-size trucks on the road. Now get up to a $5,000 cash allowance, plus a no-extra-charge Hemi engine upgrade on one of America's hottest trucks, Dodge Ram 1500.
You may not realize it, but there's a source of renewable energy right in your neighborhood, and you're helping to power it. Today, Waste Management is using the resources at our disposal to create energy from waste. Enough green energy to power over 1 million homes. From everyday collection to environmental protection, think green, think Waste Management.
An important message from Sprint. You know the feeling. You can't take care of business the way others do. It's called connectile dysfunction, a condition caused by inadequate broadband coverage. The cure? Sprint Mobile Broadband. It works in twice the cities of Singular's Broadband Connect, so you can be you again. Get a free Sprint card. Visit sprint.com/mobile broadband.
Sprint. Power up.
All right. Welcome back to Vancouver. 1-0 lead here for Dallas in the second period. Rick, I mean, a much better period for you guys. I know the goals aren't there just yet, but you guys have been all over them here this second period.
We need a goal to break the ice here and give our confidence a little bit of a lift. We're still forcing plays with the puck through to neutral zone, but the one thing we are doing better is at least we're firing more pucks to the net. And so what Coach is saying, right? We want more traffic. We're making things happen, but in order to give us another boost of confidence, something's got to go in the net. Give Turco a lot of credit. He is outstanding tonight, as he has been throughout the series. We need a break like they got in their first goal, that a puck that's going towards the net, change the direction a little bit and find its way in behind him.
Well, you got the power play right now to do it. Thanks, Rick.
And the power play underway. Here's a drive by Saddle that broke the stick of Yuri Lehtinen and then bounced off of Trevor Linden. Lehtinen, one of the penalty killers out there without a stick. Here is Henrik Sedin. Pass to the front of the net. Great anticipation by Robida, and he cleared it off the Vancouver player to center ice.
That's a huge break, so Lehtinen can go to the bench and get a stick.
Lehtinen has a fresh piece of lumber. Olin was checked by Modano as he tried to deliver that shot. Power play number four for the Vancouver Canucks, their third straight here in this second period. It's John Clem in the box, and it comes to the front. Henrik Sedin scores! Because it looks like Hansen's got as much right to that puck as Turco, but it will be a Dallas power play in this 1-1 game seven when we come back.
Dodge Ram Heavy Duty's got the cleanest, strongest diesel of any pickup with up to 650 pound-feet of torque from an available Cummins turbo diesel. It's a beast with over 2.5 tons of payload and over 8 tons of towing. Own one, and you'll know why Dodge Ram is the longest-lasting, most durable line of full-size pickup trucks on the road. Now get up to a $3,000 cash allowance, plus a no-extra-charge Hemi engine upgrade on one of America's hottest trucks, Dodge Ram Heavy Duty.
special agent, they're trying to stop you from saving time and money on auto insurance. Here's the play.
Quote by print. Got it, coach.
When there's only seconds on the clock, Esurance gives you a fast break.
From all the hassle of buying auto insurance, you don't have to jump through hoops.
At Esurance, instant comparison quotes let you screen prices yourself,
so you can net yourself some savings.
It's a slam dunk. Save time and money on auto insurance. Visit Esurance.com today.
Bill Clement at Hockey Central. The semifinal matchups are set in the East, while in the West, two scenarios could play out. Brian Engblom and Keith Jones will join me to break it all down. Plus, analysis of the second period in Vancouver. Join us, won't you, for the Verizon Wireless Intermission Report. Back to Dave, John, and Bob.
All right, Billy, thanks very much. And that is Hanson in the box. Now watch where Turco is here. And do you think Hanson has a right to go after this puck?
Well, he is going after the puck, and Turco's coming out the plate. He's just challenging that play. That's a close call, but nonetheless, Dallas goes on the power play.
Turco did a little bit of a stutter step there. I don't think Hanson was certainly intending to make contact, but once he was committed to try to play that puck. Now let's see if the Dallas Stars can take advantage of this opportunity. Still looking for their first, and we got another call here.
And it's going to be on Brendan Morrow. Now it's on Burrows. They go back to game six. A little bit of a chop.
Burrows is hurting a little bit. I would hope that Morrow was not looking for some retribution here, because not the time you want to do it.
Oh, you can see the call by Rob Schick there as Dave Tippett looks on anxiously. And Alex Burrows is hurting. And it was Morrow just defending the play because he lost the puck and he was trying to regroup it. And he just chopped to try to get the puck back, negating this, but putting it in a four-on-four situation here.
So the Sharks right now are 14-0 in this period. Dallas had a 10-6 advantage on the shot clock at the end of one. It's now 20-10 in a 1-1 game. Right wide, it comes to Daly. Drives a shot, saved by Lamont. A big rebound comes all the way out to Boucher. Now Modano back to Boucher. Another drive right through, and Luongo able to hang on. Under 4 minutes remaining in the second. Stay with us. 1-1 here in game seven on Versus.
In the end, all roads lead to Dodge Ram. That's because Dodge Ram is the longest lasting, most durable line of full-size trucks on the road. Now get up to a $5,000 cash allowance, plus a no extra charge Hemi engine upgrade on one of America's hottest trucks, Dodge Ram 1500.
Honey?
Yeah?
Do you know what this light switch does?
Which one?
The one on the right.
I never use that one.
All right, will you look?
Yep.
On? Off? On?
No.
Are you looking?
Yes.
Huh. Off. On. Off. On. Off. On. Off. On. Off.
Life comes at you fast. When it does, nobody covers your car like Nationwide. Investments, retirement, insurance.
Nationwide is on your side.
It is the ultimate test of guts and determination. 16 teams have begun a quest where the human spirit will be pushed beyond endurance.
The playoffs have started.
And only the strongest, the fastest, and the bravest will capture the greatest prize in sports. Follow the quest on Versus and NBC, then log on to NHL.com for complete playoff coverage.
Well, we mentioned at the top of the show, Roberto Luongo has given Vancouver everything they expected, but they need some offense. When they have scored, they've won, Vancouver.
And this pass was intended for Trevor Linden, and it goes right to Henrik Sedin. But sometimes broken plays are your best asset, and I believe that's what happened there. But they do connect, the Sedin twins, and it was a power play goal, and it broke the ice for Marty Turco and his shutout streak.
The Vancouver Canucks have scored a goal in this series. They have won. Turco and the Stars. Three wins all came on shutouts, 2-0 in game number two, and then back-to-back 5 and 6. Here comes Naslin now, crisscrossing with Mitchell. They got a bit confused there. And we still got four skaters aside for about 55 seconds, and then the Canucks will get Hanson back and have a short power play of their own.
Well, there was two good saves there by Luongo. One on Boucher from the point and one on Daly from the point, but both those shots getting through, so Luongo forced to track pucks from a long distance, and he's doing a good job.
Here is Naslund, sends it in wide of Turco. Boucher back to play it now for the Dallas Stars. Just over 3 minutes remaining here in the second period. If the Dallas Stars win, they'll head to Detroit, start a second round series against the Red Wings. If the Canucks win, they'll take on the Anaheim Ducks. A drive here by Nordstrom, and Luongo was turned kind of awkwardly, and that's because he was run into, he says, by Louis Erickson. And Luongo had some comments for the referee, Brad Watson, as he went by.
You're absolutely right, Dave. He objected to Brad Watson, and Watson skated by and gave him some words, too. Luongo looking for the same thing that Marty Turco got. You don't think they pay attention across the ice at what the other guy's doing? That's an indicator right there.
Here is Hansen now, sends it in wide. Dallas Stars have been given credit now for three shots here in this second period. Hansen plays it around to the point, intercepted by Barnes. Breaks now with Hagman. Morrow comes out of the box. Back to five skaters aside now. Hagman backhand shot, and it's intercepted now by Henrik Sedin and played out to center ice. Ulis just over skates it. 2 minutes straight up left here now in the second period. And the Canucks look like a much more confident team.
Oh, they absolutely do. That one goal kind of sparked this team right now, and the fans are into it.
Take a look at our Dodge storyline here late in the second period of this Game 7, the 120th Game 7 in Stanley Cup playoff history. Lundqvist, look at this move here. And off the post and in, Henrik Sedin, his second goal of the series. Of course, his first one ended Game 1 after nearly five overtimes. And Turco, first goal allowed in nearly 166 minutes.
I know you got to give a lot of credit to Marty Turco, but how about his teamwork in front of him and the job they've been doing? That's all teamwork there. Turco's getting it done, yes, but that's just a commitment to defense and desperate hockey by the Dallas Stars.
Trevor Linden with a chance here. That one just over the glove of Turco. Take a by Sopel, right point. Sends it deep, Smolinski. Now behind the net, Bullets out in front. Trevor Linden again, and he tried to go far side and missed the net. Lucas Kartek with a drive. That didn't get through. And it will be taken now to center ice. Ribeiro trying to get it in on Sopel, who stripped it away. And it's hammered into the playoff side at the Vancouver blue line.
Well, Trevor Linden had a golden opportunity, and he is Mr. Overtime and playoff scorer for the Vancouver Canucks. Look at these numbers. 5 goals, 5 assists, 10 points in Game 7 in his career, Trevor Linden.
8 career Game 7s and those kind of numbers.
Yeah, he's the active leader in that category, and he just missed a golden opportunity. Watch for Trevor Linden, though, as the game wears on and the experience. You talk about Game 7s. Experience comes out in Game 7s, as you can see the locals getting into it.
The all-time leader in terms of points in a Game 7, Doug Gilmour. A great clutch performer throughout his career with St. Louis and Toronto.
The man they call Killer for that reason. What a great competitor at 180 pounds. Doug Gilmour was a fine hockey player.
The late offside will be whistled down here by Jay Scherers, working the lines along with Greg Dvorsky. There's Trevor Linden, and of course you remember the Game 7 he was involved with the Vancouver Canucks back in 1994 in the Stanley Cup Final against the New York Rangers.
Yeah, that was an epic battle, and he had some good line mates in that game. One guy, Pavel Bure, was fantastic, but Kirk McLean in goal was equally as good. And now the names are changed, but Trevor's still around.
Less than a minute now remaining here in the second period. Daniel Sedin for Henrik. They're out there again, and they're deep. Trevor Linden, their line mate on this shift. Salo moves it along now. Henrik Sedin, pressured there by Nordstrom, who closed the gap quickly. Now Trevor Linden sends it back. Daniel Sedin out to the line. Here's Salo, fakes, lets it go, and it was blocked up high on the glass. Salo able to hold it in. Half a minute remaining in the period. Daniel Sedin has it one more time. Out to the line, Salo. Hands it off on the far side. Olin, he'll drive the shot. The save by Turco. Henrik around on the near side. Daniel has it there. Rim of the circle. Now low, return pass, Daniel Sedin, couple of shifts with the puck and underneath the fallen Dallas player. That is John Klemm, I believe, down at the bottom.
Oh, what a play by Klemm to neutralize that play, showing his physicality and sacrifice. But again, the Sedin twins walk in the circle, exchanging pucks, and there's Klemm able to neutralize the play, and a poke there by Linden after the whistle. John Klemm showing the experience.
Well, Detroit has eliminated Calgary. Anaheim has eliminated the Minnesota Wild. This series tied at 3 in San Jose, in 5 over Nashville. So if Dallas wins this, 3 of the final 4 in the West will be from the Pacific Division. How strong is that?
Oh, the West has been so strong.
The excess shot is blocked. Morrow couldn't clear the zone. Here's Nassel with a drive, and flexing the right arm as the puck went by was Turco. 1-0 seemed like such a huge lead. And when the Vancouver Canucks failed to capitalize on a 5-on-3, it looked even bigger.
And in order to reach your goals, you have to overcome obstacles. The obstacles that Marty Turco in Vancouver has done that.
15-3, the shots favoring Vancouver in that second period, 1-1 at the end of 2. Hockey Central, Bill Clement, Brian Engblom, Keith Jones. On the other side of this, you're watching Game 7 on Mercy.
When you've been building watercraft for as long as Yamaha, you don't just see a lot, you learn a lot. You learn that when you give kids more space, you somehow get closer. You learn that slowing down is just as important as going fast. And you realize the features that really matter are those on your family's faces. The 2007 Waverunner lineup from Yamaha, starting at just $7,399.
Hello, can I help you?
How much horsepower does this thing have?
That one's 19.5 horsepower.
Easy to start.
You betcha.
What's the cutting swath on this?
17 inches.
My yard has a lot of trees.
Then I'd go with the John Deere zero turn radius mower.
Do you offer financing?
Sure do. Use your Lowe's consumer credit card and pay nothing for 12 months on any purchase of $299 or more.
What is the definition of torque?
The measure of how much force on an object causes it to rotate.
Okay, store's opening and you're ready.
At Lowe's, we make sure our people know their stuff. Lowe's, let's build something together.
When you want to get away,
let's go, girls.
Enterprise Rent-A-Car will pick you up free. And get you on your way. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
On long road trips, hardworking sportscasters like us love Motel 6.
We save big and we get much needed R&R.
Sure do, Bob. You know, it's nice to get off the air, relax, and just be ourselves.
You swimming in that?
Yeah, I'm feeling it, Bob.
We'll leave the light on for you.
If kids love to eat healthy, you wouldn't need the nutrients in Florida orange juice. 1 8-ounce glass counts as almost 25% of your fruit and vegetable servings. Florida orange juice. Healthy, pure, and simple.
It comes with everything. Stereo cassette. 2D navigational system. Automatic anti-theft device. But high-mileage cars can also come with engine wear. Because they burn oil faster. So get Castrol GTX High Mileage for superior oil burn-off protection. In lab tests of 10W30, 17% better than leading conventional oils.
Hey.
Castrol GTX High Mileage. It's more than just oil. It's liquid engineering.
This is the Verizon Wireless NHL on Versus Intermission Report. Brought to you by Verizon Wireless, official wireless service provider of the NHL.
And welcome to our Verizon Wireless Intermission Report with Brian Engblom and Keith Jones. I'm Bill Clement. So we got a 1-1 hockey game. And just when you think you don't know anything, you realize you know even less. The Vancouver Canucks were so out of sync in the first period. They come out in the second, Brian. They take the first 14 shots on goal, a completely different game.
No kidding. Did they turn it around in a heartbeat? And they had to because they were so bad in the first period. What they did is they took the tactics that Dallas was using against them in the first, turned it right around and used it against Dallas in the second period. They were way better in the neutral zone, got pucks deep, and then the Sedin twins took over. Once you get in deep, number 22 and 33 are as good as any two guys in the the league, in the world, really, when it comes to cycling and puck controlling. Henrik Sedin is number 33, right side of your screen. He got it around the back of the net to his brother Daniel. Now, these guys definitely are identical twins because they know where everybody is and especially each other in every situation. You see how the two Dallas Stars defenders are way over on one side of the ice? One of the few mistakes that the Dallas defense made in that second period and for the game for that matter, they left Henrik Sedin all alone who just waited in the background, then eased to the front of the net, and then that invisible umbilical cord between Daniel and Henrik showed up. What a pass that was.
You know, one of the keys in the playoffs, your dancers have to dance, your singers have to sing. We've talked about that. But the checkers for the Dallas Stars have done more than just check, haven't they, Jonesy?
They really have. And you notice the Sedin twins scored well on the power play at even strength throughout there against Jeff Halpern's line on every shift. Halpern has done a great job. He's had help from his two line mates, Lundqvist and Stu Barnes. Barnes is a 36-year-old who's had 9 career game-winning goals in the playoffs. He is a checker now for the Dallas Stars, and this line has been instrumental in getting Dallas back into the series. Barnes has a goal in the series. Lundqvist has 2 goals in the series, one of them coming in this hockey game. And right there, Jeff Halpern scored the first goal in game 3. So this is a line that's been productive offensively, but more importantly, they've kept the Sedin twins off the board for the most part at even strength. Just 2 goals at even strength for those guys.
For the most part. And in the regular season, it's Daniel Sedin that's the goal scorer. Henrik had 10 goals and 71 assists, but in the second period, Henrik has Vancouver's goal, and he's with our Bob Beers.
All right, thanks very much, Bill, here with Henrik Sedin. Henrik, I mean, a long time coming. It must feel really good to finally get that monkey off your back and get that puck in the net there.
Yeah, for sure. It's been a long time, like I said. And still, we felt like we haven't created a lot of scoring chances. We just haven't been able to score. So we knew it's going to come, and lucky it came today.
Well, momentum really turned in that second period. You guys had all the momentum. You were getting the scoring chance. You're getting to the front of the net. What was the biggest difference there in between periods?
Nothing really. I mean, I thought we played a pretty good first period too. We got a couple of power plays here, and that really turned the momentum in the game. So we got to keep going here in the third.
All right, thanks very much. Good luck.
Thank you.
Bill, back to you.
Bob, thank you very much. In the second period, the Sedin twins outshot Dallas 7-4. When we come back, we'll look at the Western Conference semifinal scenarios. Nothing is set just yet.
'85, Gretzky makes the great one seem like an understatement. 1994, Messier backs up his mouth with his stick. 2001, Stanley Cup engraver finally has to learn how to spell Bork. 2006, Doug Weighton separates shoulder, lifts cup with his heart. 2007, the NHL playoffs on Versus. Conference semifinals begin Wednesday.
That hurt?
No.
You're all right. We'll put a little ice on. That's no big deal.
You wouldn't make it in the NHL. But you can get inside with VCast. Watch highlights, interviews, and everything hockey. Exclusively from Verizon Wireless.
The tension in the air is palpable. Robbie Knievel buses and a canyon and a double world record jump in the making. And to do it, he's strapped a huge jet engine to the back of his bike. He is moving back into the tent, which means he is going to be starting his ascent now. There he goes. Oh, my God. Robbie, he is on fire.
Robbie. Put him out, Robbie.
Oh, my. Come on, talk to me, Rob. Oh.
Robbie. Wait, there's Robbie over there!
Robbie! Let me just ask you a quick question! What happened? Did someone talk some sense into you?
No, but I did stay at a Holiday Inn Express last night.
Stay smart. Stay at a Holiday Inn Express.
You're very rectangular in shape.
Yup. It's my shape that allows me to be oh so versatile.
You know, a goat's pupils are rectangular too.
That's really creepy, man.
We got just what you need to keep your yard beautiful and weed-free. Let's start with fertilizer.
We're here because we've been there with the tools, products, and advice to get it done right. True Value. Start right. Start here.
And welcome back, everybody. There is one series that is still being played in the NHL, and it is the game you're watching tonight. Now, if Vancouver wins, these are the scenarios. Detroit will get home ice against San Jose. Anaheim will have home ice against Vancouver.
If I'm the Red Wings, I think I'm pulling for Dallas in this game. With the uncertainty of Sergei Zubov and the fact you got to face San Jose, I think Dallas would be a better fit.
And for Anaheim, either way, having a chance to get rested up and healed up, especially a guy like Francois Beauchemin, as many days as he can get under his belt will certainly help.
Jonesy, this is what you were talking about. If Dallas wins, Detroit gets Dallas.
Yeah, that would be a great series as well. There's storied history in the playoffs between those two hockey teams. Be great hockey to watch.
And Anaheim and San Jose had some unbelievable games.
That would be fantastic. Yeah. It's all good. It's all good.
You bet.
And it's going to be really good. We're on the air at 6:30 with a pregame show Wednesday. It's the Rangers in Buffalo, game one of their series. Then we're back with a doubleheader on Thursday. Then NBC takes over on the weekend. It'll be one of the scenarios you see at 3 Eastern on Saturday. And then Buffalo and the New York Rangers, game two of their series on NBC at 2 o'clock on Sunday. Lots to look forward to.
OnStar Emergency.
Help us. We are completely submerged in water, and the water is coming into the car.
I'm contacting emergency services.
How can I help you?
This is OnStar. I've got a vehicle being washed off the road, Highway 171. What's his name?
Ryan.
Hey, buddy. I've got the police and the fire department on their way.
Here comes somebody.
Ryan, it's going to be okay.
OnStar. Available on over 50 models from GM.
Every day, workers across America cover our good name with dirt, dust, paint, oil, grease, and mud. And you know what? We're fine with that. Dickies, a legend in work.
1985, Gretzky makes the great one seem like an understatement. 1994, Messier backs up his mouth with his stick. 2006, Doug Waite separates shoulder, lifts cup with his heart. 2007,
the NHL playoffs on Versus. Go to Versus.com to view and vote for your defining moment.
This is Scott from Brinks Home Security. Are you all right?
No, I think someone tried to break in the front door.
I'm sending help right now.
Brinks Home Security protected this family, and they can help protect yours, too. The Brinks J.D. Power & Associates Award-recognized monitoring center can provide a quick link to the authorities 24 hours a day. Call Brinks now and get a free security system needs analysis. The Brinks Standard System at Consumer's Digest Best Buy installed for just $99 and a second keypad installed free. That's a $125 value. Plus, you could save up to 20% on your homeowner's insurance.
Thank you so much.
Brinks Home Security, dedicated to rapid response and peace of mind 24 hours a day. Call now.
Welcome back, everybody. We want to let you know that we've got a treat coming your way for the first two nights of our semifinal coverage. Peter Laviolette, the head coach of the Carolina Hurricanes, will be joining us in studio, and he knows just a little bit about the Buffalo Sabres. And just a reminder, if you want to be part of the NHL playoff excitement, you can play along with NHL.com's Quest for the Cup. Log on to NHL.com for all the rules and prize information, and be sure to stay tuned because sometime tonight we'll give you today's code word, and that's worth 3,000 points to you. Well, it's 1-1 heading to the third period in Vancouver. Should we have expected anything less? I don't think so.
This has been the Verizon Wireless NHL on Versus Intermission Report. Brought to you by Verizon Wireless, official wireless service provider of the NHL.
There's something about the freshness of Ireland that brings out the lasses. Now it comes in a body wash from Irish Spring. Smell like you're worth exploring. New, long-lasting Irish Spring body wash. All the freshness of Ireland. Bottled.
Jack Link's Beef Jerky presents Messin' with Sasquatch.
Jack Link's Jerky. Feed your wild side.
12 state lines. 47 red pickup trucks. And 3 bouncy things. 125 windmills. 98 Joshua trees. One great place to start counting sheep. Super 8, with over 2,000 locations, free high-speed internet, free breakfast, and more. Wherever your journey takes you, you can count on Super 8. See you along the way. Super 8 is a proud member of Trip Rewards. Sign up at super8.com.
Switch to Valvoline's Max Life, and there's no telling how long your car will keep going. MaxLife not only protects against friction, but also leaks, deposits, and sludge. The 4 major causes of high-mileage engine breakdown. Long live your car.
A craftsman doesn't tidy up. He blasts everything clean. So what's in his shed? The new Craftsman 80th Anniversary Pressure Washer. It's the latest in clean. 80 years of Craftsman know-how meets the power of a Briggs & Stratton engine. Other washers stop at 4 nozzles. This is the only one with the 6-nozzle precision spray selector. And you'll never mess with changing out tips. Switch from max pressure to a high-flow rinse with the flick of a wrist. 2,700 pounds of pressure blasting 2.5 gallons per minute. There's nothing else like it to keep you moving from one dirty job to the next. And the 2-in-1 onboard detergent system takes you from deck wash to degreasing solution without slowing you down. It's a limited edition, so where can you get it? Only at Sears. It's on sale right now. And click on sears.com/clean for 6 bottles of cleaner free. Craftsman innovation helps get the job done fast, so you can get on to other projects.
The NHL Stanley Cup playoffs on Versus is brought to you by the all-new 2008 Dodge Avenger, the perfect combination of innovation, bold style, and spirited performance. Dodge, official vehicles of the NHL.
Game 7 here in Vancouver at GM Place is 40 minutes in the books, and 1-1 is our score. Dave Streeter back along with John Van Beesbrook. And, of course, the story coming into this Game 7, the fact that Marty Turco had consecutive shutouts. Would Vancouver ever get a goal? They missed on a 5-on-3, but they finally broke through.
Yeah, it didn't look like they were going to score, especially in the first period. But in the second period, they had 10 good scoring opportunities, and that led to the Henrik Sedin goal. And it was a great pinch by Matthias Olin there, and that's what their coaching staff talked about, positional pinches, and they got one.
Take a look at the goals that have been scored in this game, and of course it was Joel Lundqvist that got it started for the Dallas Stars.
Oh, it was a beautiful individual effort. You can hear the ting as he beats Roberto Luongo. And in the second period, it was hard work. Olin kept it in, and it led to that broken play, and Henrik Sedin is finally able to beat Marty Turco. Unbelievable.
And take a look at the totals here through 2 periods of play.
Well, significant is Vancouver's shots on goal. They finally broke the ice, picked up the momentum, and now we're tied going to the third.
And we are underway. And which team is going to crack first? And there's still some time remaining. As there's one Dallas player that is in the box. Well, the Vancouver Canucks working on the power play. Here's Henrik Sedin. Gets in for the shot. Save made by Turco. And the puck cleared off the near boards. Held in, though, by Salo. Salo goes to Trevor Linden. Linden at the rim of the circle takes a look. Now sends it back to the line. Salo on the far side. One timer on the way and a perfect shot block and a clear by Halpern.
Oh, shot blocking. Halpern skates off gingerly, but Dallas is able to shot block right now. But the attempts by Vancouver are intimidating Dallas.
Here's a steal by Boucher. He sends it across, and Modano has it now into the zone. Modano with a wrist shot that went in wide. Now Lindros puts it right out of front. Modano, a shot, he missed the net. Lindros cut right through the crease area. Eric Lindros playing on a line here with Modano and Morrow. So you were saying that Eric Lindros, despite the fact he hasn't played much in this series, kind of player that can make things happen. A long, bouncing, skipping puck goes just wide of Luongo. And right back the other way now.
And there's a Lindros factor right there as he back checks hard. That big body, 6'5", 240 pounds. That's a big presence, and putting him on a line with Mike Modano and Brendan Morrow might spark this team. We also have to pay attention if Jerry Lettinen's hurt or not, because he blocked two shots in the second period, so we got to pay attention for number 26, Jerry Lettinen.
Now Matthias Nordstrom has to go off his stick. Robida, his defense partner, clears away. Now Smolinski up the board, sends it back to the line. A drive here, right through, and Turco the save. As Libero tries to clear, it's held in by the Canucks. Bulis with it again. John Bulis tried to play it back to the point, intercepted by Nagy. He's got Hagman with him. Nicholas Hagman with good speed, gets the shot away. Luongo steers that aside. Now Hagman behind the Vancouver goal. Tries to walk out with it. Tipped away by Mitchell. And Mitchell able to play it up the left wing side. Smolinski, rink wide. Here comes Sopel on the angle. Into the glove of Turco, and he hangs on, getting the whistle.
Well, Turco has been brilliant, and Luongo is equal to the task. But early, a nice play here. Henrik Sedin walks through the middle and it just dangles through as Turco shows composure. And at the other end, Modano with a great opportunity just misses the net. Luongo stretching wide as Lindros and Modano look on. We'll see how they team up going to the third.
Faceoff to the left of Turco, and the puck controlled by Piatt. He tried to get it to the front, knocked away by Sedor. And hold on, is there going to be a penalty here? No, it was deflected. Let's go down to ice level and Bob Beard.
All right, thanks very much, Dave. Talk with the Dallas coaching staff after that second period. Obviously not happy with the way that second period played out. Way too many penalties, but why did they take those penalties? They felt it was a direct result of too many turnovers, especially in the neutral zone. When they did that, momentum came onto Vancouver's side. They found themselves back on their heels, and Vancouver really took it to them that period. They will change nothing, though. Even with the 1-1 tie, game seven, they want to stick with their system, their game plan. They have a ton of confidence in it.
Well, they have a ton of confidence, but you wonder if the absence of Sergei Zubov, I guess you don't wonder, you certainly know that it becomes even more evident not having him in the lineup in this 1-1 game in the third period.
Well, you talk about neutral zone. Sergei Zubov's one of the best finding his players through the neutral zone.
Here's Halpern on a loose puck, hands it off. Mark with a shot, he missed it just wide on the glove side. Dallas has had three good chances here in the early going of the third, and they've missed the net. Now Piatt, bumped by Lundqvist. Henrik Sedin for Daniel, penalty coming. It's going to go against the Dallas Stars. Joel Lundqvist called for high sticking.
Schick motioning as Joel Lundqvist goes off for high sticking, but Sergei Zubov, such an important player for the Dallas Stars, averaging 30 minutes a night, and how about those stats in playoff games? What a career for Sergei Zubov, and they missed some penalty killing as well.
Has the primary assist on all three game-winning goals in this series for the Dallas Stars. Does Sergei Zubov, and for the Vancouver Canucks, their seventh power play of this game seven. They have their only goal with the man advantage, scored by Henrik Sedin, set up by Daniel. As Naslund winding his way into the zone, it goes all the way out to the right point. Sopel chips it off now for Morrison. Morrison looking for Smolinski, or Naslund down low, goes to Naslund, oh, and fuck, Bieksa just missed it as he skated through on the Stars clear.
Oh, that's called shooting the gap as Bieksa came down looking for the backdoor play. The second unit here with Naslund, Morrison almost connecting there as Sedin is out there with him, and that's Daniel.
Here's a loose puck, Naslund backhands it wide, up high on the glass. Now it comes to Morrison, hands it off for Naslund. Naslund takes a look, gives it low. Morrison centering pass, deflects out. The shot with a drive, changes direction. Here's Morrison with it on the backhand, but couldn't get the shot away. Now Daniel Sedin walks it out, hands it to Sopel. Bieksa, under some pressure, takes it to the near boards. Now Sopel, 45 seconds left to the power play. Brendan Morrison, far side, it goes to Naslund. Haslam takes a look. Top of the circle, winds up, drives the shot, redirected just wide. Daniel Sedin got a stick on that.
Oh, looking for that direction off the side of Turkle, looking for the tip. Almost connected for Vancouver there.
Good keep in there by Bieksa, now for Brendan Morrison. Just over 20 seconds left in this power play. Turkle plays it up the boards, and Boucher able to clear.
Oh, it's a simple play by Turkle, but he helped out his defense corps, leading to a change, a needed change there. Turkle doing the simple things good as Vancouver is ignited here with this strong play on the power play.
Now Olin with it, couple of seconds remaining in the Joel Lundqvist penalty. He steps out of the box. Big kill there for the Stars. Here's Turco. He'll clear it himself all the way down to Brendan Morrow. Morrow, a little touch pass, tried to get it through to Modano. Now Salo tries to clear. That caroms off a couple of players, and Trevor Linden will lift it all the way back down. No icing here. Robidoux's going to have to go down. Cowan lining him up for a big hit. Rubs him out along the board. Now Lindgren battling with Bullitt. Puck comes free. Cowan a shot. Turco the save. And he corrals it there.
Fans are excited here. Marty Turco's composed, and the nifty stick work by Marcus Naslin as he tries to pull the puck through and just misses the side of the net. This is the redirect here. Boucher out front, his feet are in the paint, but oh, just a near miss as the puck movement by Vancouver almost connects, and it was Bullis looking for the tip. Not Naslin, but Turco has been focused all throughout this game.
Faceoff control by the Canucks. Olin off the boards for Daniel Sedin. Fights off the check from Halpern. Now Henrik over to help out. Puck comes free. Pyatt with a shot saved by Turco. Boy, did he make that look easy. And then Clem jumps Daniel Sedin, but no call coming. It's the only game seven of the first round, and it's only on Versus.
What are you doing?
Should we pick him up? He has Bud Light.
He has an axe.
But he has Bud Light.
And an axe.
I'm sure there's a reason for it.
Hey, buddy. What's with the axe?
It's a bottle opener.
Hop in.
Refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it.
Look, here's Bud Light.
In a chainsaw?
You could save with Geico Motorcycle Insurance. Enough for a day off with your special someone. Geico Motorcycle, let's ride. Whether you ride it, drive it, or tow it, Geico can help you insure it. Geico Power Sports, let's ride.
Who's counting on your brakes today? Come to Midas and get brake pads or shoes for just $89.95 per axle installed. Be safe.
Just a Midas touch.
When you want to get away,
let's go, girls.
Enterprise Rent-A-Car will pick you up free. And get you on your way. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
GM plays Game 7. Western Conference quarterfinals. Vancouver led this series 3-1. A couple of shutouts by Turco and the Stars forced the Game 7. What's going through the mind of Alain Vigneault?
Well, Alain Vigneault called out his players and his veteran players to get the job done. He wanted a harder work ethic. Well, he's gotten that in Game 7 here. Good job by Alain Vigneault to really press his players to play this Game 7 because it looked like Dallas was going to take control. I think that's experience coaching.
Johnson out 24-14 for Vancouver. Pyatt with a chance and a save by Turco. And we were saying for the longest time that Dallas was held without a shot on goal. Well, they had changed the numbers actually from the official stat sheet. Officially now Dallas had 9 shots in the first. So they went about 15 minutes of the second period with only 1 shot on goal. But the difference still pretty significant. And mostly because Vancouver's had so many power plays as the linesmen want to do this again. On the puck drop.
Well, you're going to see all these puck drops now, a battle for position. Every little situation is going to be important. The terminology from the Dallas Stars is every play counts. And when you get into defensive zone faceoffs for your team, every play does count. And that's the motto right now for the Dallas Stars. It was originated by Dave Tippett. So defensive zone faceoffs and battles for space, so important here as the game wears on.
Another faceoff win, Henrik Sedin. Here's Daniel with a dart behind the Dallas net, brings it out to the front, tried to get it through, and a penalty coming. And it's going to be a hook, I believe, against the Dallas Stars. Again, the pressure of the Sedin twins in Vancouver. This is going to be power play number 8.
11, hooking.
And that was pressure off the draw. Dave Tippett not happy. And the fans here in Vancouver are around the net, chased. Sedin, too much power. And the hook by Helbert leads Vancouver. And this crowd here is ignited in Game 7.
Well, the Vancouver Canucks, only one power play goal in this series coming in, and that came in Game 1. Well, they have gone 5 games in this series without a power play goal. They've got one. And here's Salo trying to get another one right through. Turco is knocked over into the net as he was bumped by Linden, who had been hit by Nordstrom, the puck out of play.
I think the puck went off of Nordstrom's helmet there as Linden Nordstrom were almost dinged by that shot by Salo. Watch here, Olin over to Salo for a one-timer, and right there, ducking out of the way from that bullet. Knocking into Turco is Linden. Coincidental contact, there's no call on that play, but it's heating up here. Such a battle now for time and space. Every effort counts now.
Faceoff controlled by Henrik, but darting in to pick it up was Gary Lettinen for the Dallas Stars, and he dumps it down the ice. 1-1 our score, 13 and a half remaining here in regulation time in this Game 7. Henrik Sedin hands it off far side for his brother Daniel. Back to the point, Salo with a wrist shot, didn't get through. Now the Sedins exchange the puck along the boards. Henrik sends it back to Daniel in the corner. Henrik out to the line, Salo. Back to Henrik Sedin, number 33. Takes a look, hands it off to Olin. It's a redirected! Where is it? It's in the net! Power play goal! Vancouver has the lead in Game 7.
Oh, and who is it? It's Trevor Linden, Mr. Game 7, on a beautiful redirect from Matthias Olin. Showing a different wrinkle there for Vancouver. All of a sudden, their points are getting involved. Reading the play, up top is John Klemm here trying to close down the play. What do they do? Throw it to Olin in front of the net, and you can see Trevor Linden. And he laid it, Trevor Linden, as the puck just trickles through. Turco and the Vancouver bench is excited, and so is GM Place.
34th career playoff goal, his second goal of this series, and the 6th time that he has scored a goal in a Stanley Cup playoff Game 7. Alain Vigneault, you said it, called out his veteran players, and his veteran players have delivered.
And what a great set of puck movement skills there by the Sedins to Olin, to Trevor Linden. Has his GM Place just jumping right now. Marty Turco finally beaten in the second period on a goal that has ignited this Vancouver Canuck team. They looked like they were dead coming home, Dave.
They did.
And you can only look back to last year in the Stanley Cup Final when Edmonton shellacked the Edmonton Oilers in Game 6, and it looked like it was going to be all Edmonton and Carolina. Showed why they were champions and came back. Vancouver looks like that.
Here is Cowan now. Gets a wrist shot away, steered aside by Turco. Now, what does Dallas have in the tank? They've been a great comeback team all year long. Oh, and a hit from behind by Nagy, and no call coming. The Vancouver player is okay, Brendan Morrison. But boy, we've seen lesser collisions than that called. And Nagy got away with one. Here's Bieksa with a drive, and a hit off of Cowan and went wide. Olin and Hendrik Sedin will get the assist. Now it comes to Hagman. Hagman right wide, trying to hit Boucher. Boucher able to get a stick on it, sends it in behind Luongo. Nagy gets in on the forecheck with a steal. And Nagy is stuck to the ice. Naslund tried to clear. Sends it back behind the net. Nagy waiting there for Dallas. Hands it off now for Romero. Romero looking to the front. Forced to the corner. Now Olin tried to clear, held in by Robidoux. Sent the glove, but Luongo said, I've seen enough of this. I'm going to settle it down.
Yeah, that's a smart play by Luongo to show composure. But how about here? Watch Morrison get hit from behind by Nagy. Oh, no call there. But the goal again, Turco reading the play, and the tip right here by Linden caroms off of both legs and just crosses the goal line. It's 2-1 Vancouver. Wow, what a turn of events.
Lindros wins the draw. Lindros again out here with Modano and Morrow. Modano shot tipped just wide. Morrow got a piece of that, and then Lindros and one of the Vancouver players knocked the net off the supports behind Luongo, and they're going to say it was the Vancouver player that did this.
Well, the battles are going to continue here with 11:41 to go. Luongo is going to have to track pucks again. He's going to have to look by big bodies like Lindros. Lindros has to get in front of the net and stand there and just poke and slash and hack. He needs to be a factor here in the later stages of this game.
Faceoff control, Modano back to the line. Nordstrom shot is blocked up high in the air. It's bumped down by Jan Boulis. He gets it to center ice, trying to work it deep, but couldn't get it past Nordstrom. Now it's hammered in along the boards, and it ends up into the netting and out of play.
Well, for Dallas, Eric Lindros and company, they have battled back all year long. They were down in this series, 3-1. They've had a knack to come back in the regular season. Dave Tippett likes the fight of his team. But do they have enough gas to come back again? That's the question.
They've got 11 and a half to try to get it done here in the third period. The Canucks with a 2-1 lead. If the Canucks hang on and win, they get the Anaheim Ducks beginning Wednesday night. Erickson in on the forecheck, number 21 for Dallas, along with Rivero and Yuri Lehtinen. Rivero turns and sends it back in deep. Up on the dasher, comes down to the ice. Jan Boulis with it. Couldn't get it by Louis Erickson. Sopel there to help out. He goes to Smolinski, who angles it off the boards out to center ice.
Well, for Dallas, they need their third line players to come up again. Joel Lundqvist has a goal in this game, and now he's put on a line with Mike Ribeiro and Yuri Lehtinen. So Dave Tippett switching up his lines again.
Now cleared out to center ice, and Henrik Sedin gets it in deep. Pyatt's going to get in there first for Vancouver. Trevor Daly bumps him to the board. And now Halpert pushes it along. Joel Lundqvist, who had the first goal in this game. For a while, it looked like it might be enough. But the Canucks with a couple of power play goals. Henrik Sedin and then Trevor Linden. Back to the line. Here's Daly. Wraps it around. Henrik Sedin had to go off the stick. Halpert now a centering tackle.
Roberto Luongo in the clutch. Those are clutch saves from behind the net. Sedin loses a puck. It gets bounced the other way and a quick pass. Oh, baby. What a save by Luongo. Reacting right here. Barnes has a wide open net. Willie Mitchell can't get a stick on it. He was turned the wrong way. Barnes is robbed, and they say that heroes are made in the time of crisis. How about Roberto Luongo?
Well, they showed the replay on the board here at GM Place, and the crowd still buzzing. Remember Stu Barnes, he was almost the hero in game one. He hit the crossbar. I think that was late in the third overtime.
Well, we see aggressive plays on both ends. What Vancouver needs to do is get that puck over the red line and keep dumping the puck in. Make Dallas have to come 200 feet the other way, but right there, they were guilty of a giveaway.
Big hit by Colin. He's becoming the physical presence he was in game one. Lindblad comes up with this loose puck. Oh, he is hit up high by Cowan, and Cowan now is taking a penalty. A little bit over-anxious to deliver a second hit on this shift. But Luongo has kept this a 2-1 lead for his team as he robs Stu Barnes. Look at this. What a save. Bill Clement from Hockey Central on the other side of this.
Hey, neighbor. Getting the three-burner grill, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going with the four-burner with
infrared technology.
Oh, is that the four-seater?
Yeah.
Mine seats six. Oh, and he's got the beverage center.
I go with the Choice Deck or the Trex.
My deck's gonna be 10 by 15. Maybe two decks.
At Lowe's, you'll find everything you need to make your backyard the best one on the block.
Check out the gazebo.
You got a gazebo.
Lowe's. Let's build something together.
Use your Lowe's consumer card and pay nothing for 12 months on any purchase of $299 or more.
And...
whoa, this is huge.
Open it.
Oh. Wow.
Oh, no. You wanted a fathead, didn't you?
Oh, no, honey, don't be silly. A grill is good. We needed a grill. I mean, whew. Rockin'. That's...
You wanted a fathead, didn't you?
Yep, I wanted a fathead.
When it comes to making the ultimate fan happy, only one gift is truly big enough. Fathead, are you fan enough?
So you like it?
Oh, I don't just like it. It moves me.
Bill Clement in our Versus studio. Coming up, post-game reaction and interviews from Vancouver and a definitive look at the semifinal playoff matchups. It's all ahead on Hockey Central, presented by Esurance, immediately following the game. But right now, back to Vancouver. Dave, John, and Bob.
Well, I'm sure things are a lot calmer in that studio than they are here, as Jeff Cowan is off call for tripping, but he went high right here. But I guess it was leg-to-leg contact.
Yeah, and there was a play right before it where he tried to finish a check, so Rob Schick allowed him to get away with one, but not allowed two. Lindros presence again. We'll see him in front of the net.
Face off here in the Vancouver zone in the connection control. Here is Kalinske, short-handed, one-on-one against Modano, the forward, but Modano gets a stick on it and blocks it over the glass and out of play. This is power play number five for Dallas. And they need something here just past the halfway mark of the third period of this game seven. Vancouver trying to break a two-game franchise home ice game seven losing streak.
Well, again, they have Mike Modano on the point, which they might switch here and put him up front. Put Ribeiro, well, he's just back there for the faceoff. But Modano on the point, because Sergei Zubov's not back there. And what a critical time, game seven, to lose one of your best players and best passers.
Here's Modano. Pass to himself in the neutral zone with some speed. Takes it wide. Drops it back. Ribeiro goes to the line. Boucher hands it off for Modano. Back to Boucher. Quick shot blocked in the high slot. That was Burrows who got a piece of that. Far side for Boucher. Around on the near side now. Ribeiro trying to flag that puck down, and Josh Green got it to the line, but not out. Here's Lindros with it. Lindros, centering pass, it's in the crease. Luongo run into, play continued. No call, and the puck gets by Modano.
Oh, Luongo's complaining about the contact.
Here's Ribeiro, as Turco moved up quickly to send it back down the ice. Ribeiro, at the hash marks, takes a look across, far point. Darryl Sidor with a shot, that's blocked wide of Luongo. Lindros trying to get free from Bieksa. Ribeiro tries to send it right back to the front. Brendan Morrow is bumped. Now Lindros with it. Hands it off. It goes through Morrow. Out to Boucher. A drive. Save. Rebound is loose. Ribeiro. And it's picked off by the Canucks and cleared, but not out of the zone. But the net has come off the support. The helmet has come off of Luongo.
Oh, what one-on-one battle. Oh, is Luongo grabbing on now to Ribeiro, taking exception to being run into. The young man has to keep composure in this situation. I know he's into it and he's battling, but you cannot get involved like that at this point in the game. It's too critical. There was traffic all over the place in front of his net. Here's the battle in front, right here. Luongo able to regroup and get help. Bieksa knocks the net off. What great scrambling there by Luongo. Help from his teammates. He loses his helmet, and here, Ribeiro coming in, and Luongo taking exception. He's upset. Yeah, oh, what battle, though. What battle.
The chance of MVP from the crowd here at GM Place.
Well, let's see if the MVP can put up the wall one more time.
30 seconds left of the Cowan penalty. It comes out to the line and tipped away by Jan Boulos, recovered by Boucher, and a penalty behind the play. Salo is down. He is hurt. And Yuri Letnin, I believe, is the one that's being pointed to.
Well, it's holding, but Salo going down and grimacing, showing his right knee to be a problem. But right here off the faceoff, they get tangled up. They're fighting for it, and the holding call is here. But watch Salo's right leg as it kicks out.
Oh, you know what?
His left leg got kicked out of his knee there.
That was Nagy skating by, I think, who made the cut. That's why Yuri Letnin was looking so puzzled at the referee.
You're right, Dave. It was Nagy that came through there, but what a pivotal time for Yuri Letnin to get called there. 4-on-4 here.
10 seconds left of the Cowan penalty. He'll come out to give Vancouver a power play, but no, a penalty coming against the Canucks. They set it up now for Nordstrom, top of the circle, drives a shot, it was blocked by Willie Mitchell.
Oh, big block by Mitchell there. Brad Watson showing the hook by the captain, Marcus Naslund. And here we go again for the Vancouver Canucks, digging themselves a hole just when they got out of one. Their captain takes an ill-advised hooking penalty. Oh, man. Watch here as Nordstrom comes in. And Naslund's chasing him and gets a stick up here and rides him. That's a call that has been consistent throughout the playoffs, an ill-advised play. And now Dallas with another opportunity.
Naslund goes to the box. Yuri Letnin still has a minute 36 remaining in his penalty, so it's 4-on-4. Robida being watched by Henriksen, and now Daniel intercepts. Henrik across the line, drops it off for Daniel Sedin, looking to cut in to the forehand. Turco makes the save, and Nagy, and to push it along. We've got a penalty, a slash is being called, I believe, here against Dallas. Can you believe these penalties?
And Rob Schick calling it on the drive on Nordstrom. Dave Tippett is furious, but here driving is Sedin, and there's the chop by Nordstrom, but he just got the stick. Puts his arms up. It was a good drive to the net, but the slash was just on the stick. Tippett is livid because the referees have taken over here in the later stages of the third period. It's been a penalty fest.
Well, it's a 4-on-3 power play. Dallas with two players in the box. The Canucks with one. Neither team controls the draw. Now it comes to Boucher, and he'll start it back the other way. Just over 7 minutes left here in the third period. The Canucks with a 2-1 lead. If they can hang on and win this, they will open up Wednesday night on the road at Honda Center against the Anaheim Ducks, who disposed of the Nashville Predators in 5 games in their first round series. Turco out to play the puck. Will clear it himself to the line. Bieksa able to hold it in.
Now Bieksa hands it off in the corner. Henrik Sedin takes a look. Here's Olin. Olin a shot. He missed it up high. And a carom all the way back out to center ice.
Now Olin has two goals in the series so far and an all-important assist on Linden's goal. He's got the hot hand. You need to give it to number two.
It comes back to Olin. They did try to get it to him. Henrik Sedin now for Daniel Sedin. Back to Henrik. Takes it down low to the corner. 6:25 to go in the third. Bieksa winds up, drives a shot in the glove of Turco, and he quickly moves it. He doesn't want a whistle here. And that is a heads-up play, and here's one-on-one Halpert against Olin. Halpert goes to the outside. Tough angle here, gets a shot away, and that was a save by Luongo. And how about that individual effort by Jeff Halpert?
And the play by Marty Turco to keep the play alive. Marty Turco so gifted and agile with that puck, and he showed you why there.
Four skaters aside as Lehtinen has come out of the box. Here is Jiri Lehtinen. He takes a line, gets the shot off the blocker of Luongo. And Olin leaning on the Dallas player. Now it's taken by Modano. Tried to go back to the point. He finds a way to get it across. Here's Sidor with a shot, or rather, that was Trevor Daly on the left side. Now Naslund comes out, and the Canucks once again enjoy a 5-on-4 here for the 10 seconds remaining of the Nordstrom penalty. A steal by Daly, and he sends it back into the Vancouver zone.
Well, Vancouver certainly turning up the heat right now in a battle of time and space. You can see the desperation on both teams, chopping, hacking, and whacking.
Trevor Linden gets a loose puck, and little stop there by Turco. A broken play, and Trevor Linden very nearly had his second of this game seven. Lead pass now for Ribeiro. Across the line. He looks for some help, hands it off. Robidoux pushes it for a drive. Luongo again bumped into by Brendan Morrow, made the save. Luongo looking for the puck behind him. And it had come out in front, and a penalty coming, and I believe it's going to go against two players here. Rob Schick indicating the two guys are going to go. 5 minutes remaining here in game seven. You're watching on Versus.
Bobby Knievel buses and a canyon, a jet engine, and a double world record jump in the making. Sounds like he is about to come out. There he goes. Oh, yeah. It's a terrible scene, ladies and gentlemen. He is on fire.
Robbie!
There's Robbie over there!
Robbie!
Let me just ask you a quick question. What happened? Did someone talk some sense into you?
No, but I did stay at a Holiday Inn Express last night.
Stay smart. Stay at a Holiday Inn Express.
This lush expanse of green does more than beautify our world. Trees help clean the air of carbon dioxide, a major greenhouse gas. As North America's largest recycler, last year alone, Waste Management recycled enough paper to save over 41 million trees. From everyday collection to environmental protection, think green, think Waste Management.
So it's down to Sprint Mobile Broadband and Singular Broadband Connect.
Great.
Great.
We need powerful coverage. Is your network in Denver?
No. Yes. Pittsburgh?
Yes.
No. Minneapolis?
No.
Yes.
Sprint
Rochester?
Mobile Broadband no. works in twice yes. as many cities no. as yes. Singular's no. Broadband
yes.
Connect.
Yes. Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Buffalo?
No.
Yes. Eugene?
Wait, what was that?
Buffalo.
Oh, no.
Yes.
Omaha?
Yes. Richmond?
Yes.
Get a free Sprint card. Yes. Visit Sprint.com/mobile broadband.
Colorado Springs?
Yes.
Sprint. Power up.
Lansing.
The NHL Stanley Cup Playoffs on Versus is brought to you by Esurance. Make it your goal to save on auto insurance. Visit Esurance.com today.
Dave Strader, John Van Beesbrook, and Bob Beers. Game 7, 4:51 remaining. We've got four skaters aside. Here's the exchange, Lindros and Linden. Linden is called for an unsportsmanlike dive. I mean, Trevor Linden's not a diver. He was trying to get out there and play the puck.
Yeah, he was, but Rob Schick just trying to even things up here because it's been a penalty-filled third period. Not that bad of a call, though.
And a cover-up here by Luongo. Those two penalties, the seventh and eighth minor penalties of this third period. And the crowd just reacting to the call against Trevor Linden.
Either way, it's still 4-on-4, so you just got to keep battling on. You can't worry about the calls at this point in the game.
O'Donnell sends it back to the line. It went over the stick of Boucher. Turco comes out quickly to handle it. Now Turco plays it all the way out to center ice. Brendan Morrow for O'Donnell. O'Donnell far side. Daryl Sador has it there. 4.5 remaining in the third. Vancouver hanging on to a 2-1 lead here in this game. 7. Sador with a shot that was blocked by Daniel Sedin. Sador will get it back from O'Donnell. Now for Boucher. Boucher takes a look. Hands it off between the circles. It comes to Modano. Quickly back far side. Sador back to Modano. One timer. He hits the crossbar. Oh, and Modano just looks up to the ceiling.
What great puck movement there to Modano. Morrow to Modano. The puck movement had Luongo beat. It just shanked a little bit high for him and hit off the post. What an opportunity.
Here comes Naslund with some speed into the zone. Robidoux keeping him to the outside. It comes to the line now. Sopola wrist shot. And Turco bumped in front there by Brendan Morrison. Let's hear the sound that every goaltender likes to hear.
Every goalie likes to hear it, but Mike Modano with a golden opportunity looking up to the rafters. An unfortunate break. What great puck movement there between Boucher, Modano, Morrow led to that opportunity. Oh boy, how's this one going to play out with 3:44 to go? You can see the desperation in everybody in the building.
54 seconds remaining in the coincidental minor penalties. We're playing 4-on-4 here as Olin sends it deep for Morrison. Given a shove there by Stefan Robidoux. Now back to Naslund. Naslund trying to get away from Trevor Daly. Daly forces him to the corner. Now Daly moves it to the far side. Robidoux checked by Brendan Morrison. Now Robidoux was bumped there by Naslund. And Daly will chase down this loose puck. Just over 3 minutes remaining here in the third period. Dallas needs a goal to even this thing up. Nagy trying to get in on Olin, who plays him well. Now Nagy trying to go back to the point. Robidoux, nice pass across. Here is Daly with a drive. Puck save, Luongo, and he holds on.
Trevor Daly has a good shot. But that guy, Roberto Luongo, keeps saving him. And he does it with concentration and effective positioning. Look where he is, out at the top of his crease. He's got a great glove hand. He spent a lot of time this morning in the pregame skate working with Ian Clark on those very types of moves, and it's paying the dividends. Fundamentals always do.
10 seconds left in the coincidental minors. Face-off win by the Stars. Boucher puts it in deep. Brendan Morrow. And it was cleared out along the near board. Modano got a stick on it. We're back to 5 skaters aside as the 2 players that were in the box, Linden for Vancouver, Lindros for Dallas, are out. 2:40 remaining here in the third period of this game 7. Winner moves on, loser goes home. Now Luongo settles it down for Bieksa back behind the net. Long pass for Jan Mulas. Vancouver will just want to get it in deep. Linden in on the forecheck, puts the hit on Norstrom. Now it'll be chased down by Henrik Sedin. Lindros able to help work the puck free as Boucher for Dallas. Center ice now for Hagman. Knocked away from him. Lindros for Philippe Boucher. 2 minutes remaining here in regulation. Now it comes to Yuri Lehtinen. Vancouver player went down on the neutral zone and dumped in on Luongo. Here's Ribeiro over skates. Recovers to send it back in deep. Hagman trying to come out of the corner with it. And the referee Schick trying to get out of the way. Robidoux winds up for a shot. Saved. Luongo gave up a rebound. It's batted away by Lehtinen. Down to the near board. Hagman again pushes it along behind the net. Ribeiro is there. Ribeiro has it on his forehead. He is shoved to the ice. Now it comes out to Robidoux. Penalty coming, or are they just pulling the goalie? I believe they are just pulling Turco. There is no penalty here. And will it be icing? Yes. Turco has gone to the bench. Extra attacker will be on for this face-off deep in the Vancouver zone. Well, how did we get here? How about Joel Lundqvist off the post late in the first period? Henrik Sedin on the power play tied it. Then this goal by Trevor Linden. And then Roberto Luongo takes over, but gets some help from the crossbar.
Oh, great plays at both ends of the ice. And with a minute 14 to go here, Dave Tippett taking a wise timeout. Vancouver Canucks veteran Trevor Linden has the winner right now. And he has been Mr. OT for the Vancouver Canucks, the active leader in that department. But what do the Dallas Stars have to do here? First of all, they got to play for a one draw and get their shots through or behind the net. Allow their big players, such as Lindros and Morrow, to post up and get in front of the net. That's what they need to do. Make sure you don't get a shot blocked. That's exactly what Dave Tippett's telling his players. And from the Vancouver Canucks side, they have to do what they've been doing and not leave their feet. That's so critical here. I know they like to block shots, but you cannot leave your feet with a minute to go to try to block a shot. You need to make yourself big, have active sticks, and be in lanes.
Dave Tippett comes out with Mike Modano, Mike Ribeiro, Brendan Morrow, Eric Lindros, Daryl Sedor, Philippe Boucher. Empty net down to our left. And 18,000 fans standing and waving. The white towels here. And a conversation, Rob Schick, the veteran referee, over at the bench talking to Elaine Vigneault. And this may be about an attempted change by the Vancouver coach as Malinsky was starting to come over the boards. Vancouver as a franchise has lost the last six playoff games when they've had a chance to eliminate their opponent. That is a streak they are trying to break here with a faceoff to the left of Luongo. Lindros against Morrison. A shares the linesman. Talking to both centermen. Gets them separated. Lindros wins it cleanly. Back to Boucher. Boucher hands it off to Ribeiro. Back to Boucher. One-timer is blocked. And the Canucks have it at center ice. Morrison hands it off. High in the open net. Yes!
Well, they won the draw to Dallas. And what happened? They got the shot blocked. And an all-in-court block by Taylor Pyatt. He blocked the shot. And who's the recipient of that goal and that unselfish play by Brendan Morrison? Watch here. The shot. It's going to come from the middle. Right there. Taylor Pyatt blocks it. Pushes it up. Brendan Morrison gives it back to Pyatt. And he ices the game. Vancouver Canucks doing the greatest things, and that's sacrifice. As you see the bench, you get rewarded for paying the price. Taylor Pyatt in that case got the reward for the sacrifice. You reap what you sow.
Well, you said it. Don't leave your feet to block the shot. Make yourself big. That's exactly what Pyatt did, and he got the reward. Turco goes to the bench. Extra attack run again. Here's Trevor Linden with it. Going to try to add another one. Sends it across. Malinsky scores! And that will do it. The Vancouver Canucks will advance to the second round with a Game 7 win here. Next stop, Southern California and the Anaheim Ducks.
Well, the picture tells a thousand words. And for the Dallas Stars, a triumphant comeback to force Game 7. With GM Place and this whole crowd. That's what you play the regular season for, to win the Game 7 at home. The Vancouver Canucks won the Northwest to get home ice advantage to do this right here.
Vancouver had 105 points winning their division. Dallas had 107, but they're in that very tough Pacific. So even though they had more points, because Vancouver won their division, they automatically got one of the top three seeds. And Roberto Luongo and all the Vancouver Canucks were being asked questions about historical failures by the Vancouver Canucks, not winning in Game 7, not closing out opponents. And Roberto and the rest of the Canucks said, we don't care about any of that. If you had told us at the beginning of the season, we're going to get a Game 7 in front of these fans in the first round of the playoffs with a chance to move on, we would have taken it. Well, they have taken it, and they have run with it, and they have won it.
So much Sedin's came through. And how about their ace, veteran player Trevor Linden, scoring the go-ahead goal in the game winner. But Marty Turkle, what a valiant effort in defeat. Dave Tippett, a brilliant coaching job. But it ends in game seven, and it's apropos for these two evenly matched teams. The Vancouver Canucks, though, showing the championship quality and a championship-type goaltender, Roberto Luongo. He was all the difference in that third period.
Anaheim and Vancouver will be meeting in a playoff series for the first time in their histories, and that sets up a pretty good matchup in the other series in the West, with Detroit taking on San Jose, and now the traditional handshakes after seven games. That expression on Mike Modano's face says it all as well. Lindros and Linden were the first to shake hands. Of course, they were involved in that collision late in the third period, where Linden was called for the unsportsmanlike dive and Lindros for the penalty as well.
Well, and you can go back to game six and the whole series. Morrow getting involved with the bench with Burrows. And how about that guy, Marty Turco? Played brilliant in defeat. Three shutouts. Tied the record for the longest stretch and not allowing a goal in his career. I mean, what more can you expect from a goaltender? Not much more. He plays the puck well. But the goaltending matchup was an epic. Roberto Luongo in that third period was just huge. That save on Stu Barnes was magnificent. But what a great tradition in sports, and especially in the Stanley Cup playoffs, as the players exchange their hands.
El Turco and Luongo were both last in their respective lines, and Roberto talking to Mike Smith, the backup goaltender. A lot of respect being shown for Marty Turco by these Vancouver Canucks, and there's Marty Turco and Roberto Luongo with some words for each other.
You know, Dave, there's nothing like great goaltending in the Stanley Cup playoffs. But Roberto Luongo, I got to tell you, in his first playoff experience, showed the fight of a champion. I mean, he wanted to fight Ribeiro in the third period, and that's what you can expect from your best player on your team. And in this case, he's their hope.
Roberto Luongo passing his stick over to a lucky fan, and I don't know if the fan that was, well, now Roberto's gonna tell him who's supposed to get it. I think there's a young fan there, and Luongo quickly ends that altercation by designating who was supposed to get the stick. And now let's go down to Bob Beers with Luongo.
All right, thanks very much, Dave. Roberto, how does this feel? Unbelievable. You made some great saves there down the stretch. You made plenty of big saves here in this whole series.
Yeah, it was a tight series the whole way, and Marty played unbelievable on the other end, so it could have gone either way. I'm just happy that we're moving on.
I think a few of these people are chanting your name right now. How does that feel?
Oh, it feels great. I mean, we've worked hard all year, and it's nice to get rewarded like that.
You know, after coming into this one, everybody was kind of laying you guys out there. You had lost two in a row, but you guys pulled together. That second period is fantastic for your team.
Yeah, I mean, we didn't have the first period we wanted to, but we came back strong in the second. We got some power plays, and we got a huge power play goal that we weren't getting in the previous games.
All right, Roberto, good luck in the next series. Thank you. David?
All right, Bob, thanks very much. And, of course, the game-winning goal was scored by the guy that we talked about as being Mr. Game 7.
Well, the veterans came through. It was Olin to Linden, and Trevor Linden again, Mr. Vancouver Canuck, coming through for this team, showing the fight, the championship spark. But how about forcing game seven and the reason why you played a regular season? Unbelievable.
Trevor Linden now with Bob Beers. Bob?
All right, thanks very much, Dave, here with Trevor Linden. Trevor, obviously the big game-winning goal by you, standing in front of the net, a lot was made. Look, we got to get people to the front of the net. We got to get traffic in front of Marty Turco if we're going to beat this guy.
Yeah, you know, he played so well for them, and, you know, there were nights, I mean, we hadn't scored in two games, so we were really pushing hard. Henrik Sedin scored a huge goal in that second period to give us a little lift, and Ole made a good play. He shot it wide, and I tipped it, and I thought it got through his legs, but I didn't know if it had enough to get in the net, and I didn't see it till afterwards. Felt pretty good, obviously.
Now, your coach really came out and challenged not just you, the leadership, all the big players, all the players on your team to come out and play better. Not happy with that game six, and especially the Sedin Twins, you guys really responded.
Yeah, we didn't play well in game six, and everyone knew it, and we didn't have to be really even told. But, you know, we responded in the right way, and that's the important thing. We really played a good game. We came out a little tentative tonight, I thought, and I think our game really got going in the second period.
All right, Trevor, good luck in the next round. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
David?
All right, great job down there, Bob, at ice level. John Van Biesbroek, you played in a couple of game sevens and won both of them, I might add, and there's nothing like good goaltending, great goaltending when you get down to a situation like this.
Oh, it was fantastic. And, you know, they're marathon series when it gets to a game seven, and it's not how you start, it's how you finish. Luongo made the difference in this series, and you knew that he had the qualities to do it, and now that he's proved it, watch out the rest of the NHL, because nobody would want to face a hot goaltender in the Stanley Cup playoffs, and that's what you're going to see in the Vancouver Canucks.
Joel Lundqvist scored the first goal of this Game 7, but then it was four unanswered by the Vancouver Canucks. Henrik Sedin, Trevor Linden, Taylor Pyatt, and Brian Smolinski, the last two, into the empty net. 4-1 the final score. So for John Van Biesbroek, Bob Beers, and our entire Versus crew here at GM Place, I'm Dave Strader. Now let's get you back to Hockey Central, presented by Esurance, Bill Clement, Brian Engblom, and Keith Jones. Guys?
All right, Dave, thank you very much. What a hockey series. I mean, final score in this game, 7-4-1, but that doesn't come close to telling the story. If you went back and looked at video, looked at these games, you will never find a more competitive, evenly matched series than this one. And it took a man that really is Mr. Game 7 to get it done for Vancouver when it was on the line, Trevor Linden. Now active players, he is number one in Game 7 points with 12 ahead of Jaromir Jagr.
That is phenomenal. Oh. I mean, to be in nine Game 7s in the first place,
right,
just kind of blows my mind, but they have that kind of production in Game 7 is off the chart.
There's Clutch, and then there's Trevor Linden.
Yes.
Our Dodge goal of the game goes to Trevor Linden. And you heard him tell Bob Beers that he knew he deflected it, but he didn't know if it had enough steam to make it all the way between Marty Turco's pads to get to the back of the net. He noticed it when he skated around behind the net, and that's when he started to celebrate. First impressions on this series.
Well, I give Alain Vigneault a lot of credit. Number one, getting after his team after Game 6, and then making the switch on the power play. That's Trevor Linden playing on the power play with the Sedin Twins. They scored two power play goals in this hockey game. Linden, obviously, a major factor. Looking at his record in previous Game 7s, it seems like a no-brainer for Vigneault. But he goes out, he makes the right choice, and Trevor Linden rewards him for it.
You know what was really astonishing is the number of penalties in the second and third period by both teams.
Yep.
And that really turned it on its ear. Dallas Stars took a couple of bad penalties in that second period. Vancouver got a lot of life. You heard some of the players refer to that after the game. Those are the kind of things that you just can't do. Sometimes they take a life of its own, and Dallas just undid themselves there. I feel bad for Marty Turco. I mean, how can you not feel bad for him? He played some unbelievable hockey, and he still loses another series.
I can't remember a series where both goaltenders were as brilliant as this series, both Luongo and Marty Turco. Okay, so the matchups are set. We're going to kick it off here on Versus Wednesday, 6:30 Eastern. We'll have our pregame show. Then at 7 Eastern, Rangers in Buffalo. Then Wednesday, we've got, or at least the second game of our doubleheader on Wednesday, will be Vancouver and Anaheim at 10 Eastern. Then on NBC on the weekend, San Jose against Detroit at 3 Eastern on Saturday. Buffalo Rangers, their game 2 o'clock on Sunday. That's on NBC. And we'll be back to our Versus studio after this.
Special agent, they're trying to stop you from saving time and money on auto insurance. Here's the play.
Quote by print. Got it, coach.
When there's only seconds on the clock, Esurance gives you a fast break.
From all the hassle of buying auto insurance, you don't have to jump through hoops.
At Esurance, instant comparison quotes let you screen prices yourself,
so you can net yourself some savings.
It's a slam dunk. Save time and money on auto insurance. Visit Esurance.com today.
When you want to get away,
let's go, girls.
Enterprise Rent-A-Car will pick you up free and get you on your way. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Pass it. Come on. Come on. Come on. Put it in the zone.
Yeah, put it in the zone.
Come on.
You wouldn't make it in the NHL.
But you can get inside with VCast. Watch highlights, interviews, and everything hockey. Exclusively from Verizon Wireless.
Introducing the all-new Dodge Avenger. The all-new Dodge Avenger. It's a natural performer.
Switch to Valvoline's Max Life, and there's no telling how long your car will keep going. Max Life not only protects against friction, but also leaks, deposits, and sludge, the four major causes of high mileage engine breakdown. Long live your car.
1985, Gretzky makes the great one seem like an understatement. 1994, Messier backs up his mouth with his stick. 2001, Stanley Cup engraver finally has to learn how to spell Bork. 2006, Doug Waite separates shoulder, lifts cup with his heart. 2007,
the NHL playoffs on Versus. Conference semifinals begin Wednesday.
Hockey Central on Versus is presented by Esurance. Make it your goal to save on auto insurance. Visit Esurance.com today.
Hockey Central presented by Esurance, Engblom, Jones, Clement. So, the Dallas Stars fall to the Vancouver Canucks tonight in Game 7. And coming in, pretty good bet that the goaltenders were going to have the force field up. If you were looking for soft goals in this series, you'd have to look really, really hard and deep and long because Roberto Luongo and Marty Turco were ready to roll. Now, in the playoffs, teams leading at the end of the first period with 25-1, and Joel Lundqvist gave Dallas a 1-0 lead at the end of one.
Then in the second period, number 33 in the middle of your screen, on a power play, sneaks in behind Henrik Sedin, and it's 1-1. And then Marty Turco mishandles the puck a little bit, gets run into by Yannick Hansen, and it ends up in a penalty situation.
Third period, tied at one. Vancouver on the power play. Trevor Linden right there with the eventual game winner, his second of the playoffs. That made it 2-1, and then Roberto Luongo closed the door, robbing Stu Barnes right there, smothering the rebound, no second chance. Mike Ribeiro tries to stuff it in the empty net. No goal there as well.
And then he gets some luck and some help there, too. The one-timer from Mike Modano off the crossbar and missed.
I guess you make your own breaks, huh?
You bet.
What a fantastic series. The only series in the first round of the playoffs that went to a Game 7, and it lived up to the advanced billing, especially in the goaltending department, but the Canucks advance. So here's what we've got in the semis in the West. Detroit will have home ice. They will face the San Jose Sharks.
What
the Sharks
series
won the season series 3-1. Anaheim gets Vancouver.
That Detroit-San Jose series is going to be awesome. We'll find out if the extra guys that they added this year, the strength and size that Detroit has, is going to make a difference. It showed certainly in the first round against Calgary. San Jose has got a terrific team. They're big and they're fast. What a great matchup this is going to be.
Anaheim-Vancouver, Brian Burke, the GM of the Anaheim Ducks, the former GM of the Vancouver Canucks. It's going to be a fantastic series. They are tough, the Anaheim Ducks, and they're physical. They're going to get a lot of traffic in front of Luongo. But Anaheim also has a big, strong goaltender in J.S. Chiguer that really covers a lot of them. Yeah, Brizgalov was great at the start of the last series, too.
So. That's going to be good any way you look at it. It'll be interesting to see how much gas Vancouver has got left because Anaheim is loaded. I mean, you got to think that Anaheim's going to be a decided favorite, as brilliant as Roberto Luongo was. Okay, going to take a peek at our salary cap challenge. And hey, I'm climbing on Jonesy. All right.
Gaining on me, Bill. Slow it down,
Bill. I got a good manager. Yours is pretty good, too. Brian.
No shots.
Brian. Ingy.
Hello?
He knew what he was doing.
Is this thing working? Hello?
I don't know what's happening. Matchups are set in the West. The matchups are also set in the East. When we come back, we'll look at the Eastern Conference and break it down.
Welcome to Avis. Can I help you, sir?
I'll take this one.
Turn the power up. Queen of Puzzle Rose, so I can hear my favorite song, so let's go.
Avis gives you free music downloads on iTunes, so you can rock every time you roll. Ultimate test of guts and determination. 16 teams have begun a quest where the human spirit will be pushed beyond endurance.
The playoffs have started.
And only the strongest, the fastest, and the bravest will capture the greatest prize in sports. Follow the quest on Versus and NBC, then log on to NHL.com for complete playoff coverage.
Own a timeshare or campground membership? Turn it into cash.
Timeshares Only got us our full asking price before our next monthly payment was due.
Timeshares Only is the nation's largest, number one, most successful timeshare agency, representing properties from the biggest names in the industry.
No one sells more timeshares.
Call now and receive a free information kit, including 10 secrets to timeshares. You owe it to yourself to work with the best.
Don't delay. Call 800-219-4927.
This May, the USA takes on the world with one goal in mind. Bring back the cup. The America's Cup sets sail this May on Versus.
Central on Versus is presented by Esurance. Make it your goal to save on auto insurance. Visit Esurance.com today.
And welcome back, everyone. For you fans playing NHL.com's Quest for the Cup, as promised, tonight's code word is rink. And good luck to everyone in your quest. And for complete info on how you can begin your own Quest for the Cup, log on to Versus.com or NHL.com. Well, now we are down to eight teams left, four in the West, four in the East. The Eastern Conference matchups in the semis are Buffalo and the New York Rangers, with the Sabres having home ice advantage, the New Jersey Devils and the Ottawa Senators, with New Jersey having home ice advantage. Guys, what do you think about Buff and the Rangers?
Well, what happened in the regular season doesn't matter at all. They haven't played each other since December 1st, and the New York Rangers are a totally different team now than they were then. I know the Auger-Nylander line will be really good. The Cullen line and Shanahan line is going to have to be really good for the Rangers to get balanced scoring, and their defense is going to have to play solid because they're going to be overmatched against four really, really good lines for the Buffalo Sabres. On top of that, Lundqvist, the goaltender, it always comes back to him. Lundqvist has to be brilliant if they're going to beat Buffalo.
Devils-Senators, a rematch of the 2003 Eastern Conference Finals. That went seven games. I would expect this series to be very similar. Both teams have very good scoring top lines and good checking lines to go along with it. The goaltending obviously favors New Jersey. Brodeur is a better goaltender, at more a better career than Ray Emery. Emery has improved, though, and played very well in the first round in the playoffs.
And I'm thinking long series, perhaps in the East and in the West.
Yes. Yeah, I don't think anything's going to change there. Goaltending is so good everywhere.
Well, congratulations to the Vancouver Canucks. They are the last team to advance to the second round, and they did it with a 4-1 victory over the Dallas Stars in a thrilling Game 7 tonight from Vancouver. So we look forward now to the second round, the semifinals. San Jose will meet Detroit, New Jersey will meet Ottawa, but we turn our attention on Versus to Buffalo and the New York Rangers, Game 1, 6:30 Eastern Wednesday evening. The pregame show will begin. We'll have Peter Laviolette, the head coach of the Carolina Hurricanes, with us. We're looking forward to that. Then Vancouver, Anaheim at 10 Eastern. For Brian Engblom and Keith Jones, I'm Bill Clement. Join us Wednesday, will you not? We'll see you then.
When you want to get away,
let's go, girls.
Enterprise Rent-A-Car will pick you up free and get you on your way. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Introducing the all-new Dodge Avenger.
Commence heat-seeking missile test.